Hello again and welcome back to our course on Project 2016 Advanced. In this section we're going to start to look at earned value analysis. I am going to assume that you have come across earned value analysis before, but even so I'm going to start in this section by clarifying the terminology and just explaining some of the ways in which Project 2016 does earned value calculations for us. And then in the next section, I'll take a look at one or two examples of earned value analysis using our website project. And we're starting off with version 16 of the website project here. Now let's start with some very basics of terminology. What I've got here is a 4-day task. And let's say that the value of this task is $100. It doesn't really matter what I mean by the value as such. Let's just say that as far as my project's concerned, the value of this task to the project is $100. If I assess the situation at the end of the second day, so this is at the end of Tuesday, and I decide that although I'm halfway through the duration of the task, I've actually achieved 3/4 of the outcome, so I'm 3/4 of the way through producing the result, that is clearly a good situation to be in, or at least it appears to be, because I seem to have done more work than I was scheduled to do. But supposing that in order to do that, I had used twice as many resources. So although I've achieved 3 days worth of value, I've used 4 days worth of effort, so 2 people for 2 days. Now this simple example explains what earned value analysis is all about. It's not enough to say I am a certain proportion of the way through a task, therefore this is the situation. You also need to know how much of the value of the task you've achieved. If you're halfway through, that doesn't necessarily mean you've achieved half of the value. And you also need to know the cost of what you've done. Again, you may be halfway through the duration of a task. That doesn't necessarily mean that you've used half of the amount of cost that you'd allowed for. You may have used a lot more than half of the cost. As I say, you may have had 2 people working on it instead of one. You may have used less than that amount of cost. Maybe somebody only had to work on it half time, and yet they've still got half of the value of the task done, but with less than half of the cost. So a key aspect of earned value analysis is the ability to look at both cost and value. It's no good looking at one or the other. You have to compare the two. You have to look at both. Not only what have I achieved, but how much effort went into what I have achieved. And then there is a second aspect as well to earned value analysis, and that's this. We don't look at it as an absolute set of metrics. The way that we look at earned value is by comparing cost and value with what we budgeted for. What did we originally think we were going to do? Or to be more specific, with the baseline that we're comparing progress against, what was our baseline cost and our baseline value, and what is now our actual cost and our actual value? And are the actuals better or worse than the baselines? And that's really the second element of earned value analysis. Now, fortunately for us, the way that earned value analysis works is that it represents this set of calculations as a set of statistics. Some values that I'm going to talk to you about next. And these are really the values of earned value analysis. These are not specific or particular to Project 2016. When you talk about earned value analysis, it's not associated with any particular planning or scheduling product or methodology. But what Project 2016 does for you is that it calculates these values. So you measure progress in your projects as well as you can. You set everything up. You make sure you've got a good baseline, etc. And Project 2016 does the rest. It calculates these important values, these important statistics that tell you how well you are doing in terms of cost, in terms of value, in terms of your schedule. So let's look now at what these statistics are. And in order to do this, I'm going to review what's in the Project 2016 help. Now, there's actually a pretty good help topic on earned value analysis. And I suggest that if you've got any doubts about the theory, you're not familiar with earned value analysis, or even if you've got a reasonable grasp but you just like to make sure that you understand it as accurately as you need to, then I do suggest you work through this help topic. I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but the example here is a pretty good example and will give you a specific case of what I've just been describing. But what I want to do with the content here is to actually move down to the sections that describe the key statistics. So the first three key statistics are PV, AC and EV. And when you're working on earned value analysis and reporting earned value, you'll see these three terms quite a lot. PV is planned value. Now, all of these are basically measured at your status date. So at the point where you are recording status on a project, what was the planned value? Now, there is an alternative term for PV, and that's BCWS. And in some ways, BCWS is a more helpful term. It's the budgeted cost of the work scheduled. So, given where we've got to, what was the budgeted cost? How much did we think that we would spend to get here? So that's PV. The second term is AC, and that's actual cost. And the alternative term for this is ACWP. This is the actual cost of the work performed. So given where we've got to, what has our cost actually been? And the third term is EV, earned value. And the alternative here is BCWP. And this is, what is the budgeted cost of the work performed? So the difference between the first one and the third one, which are both budgeted costs, is the first one says, what was the budgeted cost of the work we were scheduled to perform? And the third one, BCWP, what was the budgeted cost of the work we've actually performed? And the middle one is the actual cost of the work we've actually performed. Now, as I mentioned just now, Project 2016 calculates these for you, but it's important to understand what those three terms mean, and I think what might loosely be called the old-fashioned terms for those, BCWS, ACWP, BCWP, particularly if you're new to earned value analysis, really are probably easier terms to understand, but you'll find that PV, AC and EV are probably more commonly used nowadays. And now in that same help topic, there's a little graphic just further down from the definitions you just saw. It's a really helpful little graphic. If you look at the top one there, there's a planned budget for a project. Nice diagonal line there. And then below that, we've got a project that's going badly. You can still see the diagonal line, if you like, the scheduled. But the project is not performing and it's costing more to do everything that we're doing. So the actual cost of the work performed is high, and we're actually earning less than we should be, so the earned value is low. The budgeted cost of the work performed is low. So EV is low, AC is high, things are not going well. So having looked at that basic terminology, the next thing to do is to switch back into our website project and look at some of the earned value calculations as performed by Project 2016. This is version 16 of the website project, and what I'm going to do is to look at the earned value tables. There are actually three earned value tables. So more tables, and there are three: earned value cost indicators, and earned value schedule indicators. Now let's start with the earned value table. Now, bearing in mind that your tables may have already been customized compared to the standard, what you will normally see in the earned value table, first of all, is a set of three columns corresponding to PV, EV and AC. Note that within each of those, there is the equivalent acronym PV is BCWS, etc. And if you hover over the header of each of those, there's a brief description of what that particular statistic represents in earned value terms. Now, these are the three statistics that I've referred to already, so I won't dwell on those. But one point I will make here, and try not to keep repeating myself, remember that Project 2016 calculates these for you. So what you really need to be able to do is to understand what each of these means and where to use them, rather than necessarily just how to calculate them. Now, to the right of these three, we have two more very important statistics. We have SV and CV. Schedule variance and cost variance. In the case of schedule variance, you can see the formula there. SV is BCWP minus BCWS. And above that, there is a verbal description of what SV means. It's the difference in cost terms between the current progress and the baseline plan of a task. Now, in this column at the moment, you can see that most of the entries have a $0, which means for any task that in cost terms it is going to schedule. Where you have a negative cost, that means that in cost terms the task is behind schedule. In particular, if you look at the task 0, which is the project summary task, the fact that there is a negative SV value means that overall the project is behind schedule. Now, the next column is CV, or cost variance. And CV is calculated as BCWP minus ACWP. And it is the difference between how much it should have cost and how much it has actually cost to achieve the current level of completion. Now, once again, if everything was going to plan, that would be a column of zeros. But the negative values indicate that we are spending more than the earned value deserves. Or if you like, we're spending more to do the work than we should be spending. So a negative cost variance is also bad news. Now, the final three columns here all anticipate what will happen at the end of the project. So we have EAC, which is estimate at completion. There is a formula there that shows you how EAC is calculated, and it is the expected total cost of a task based on performance up to the status date. Now, one of the values in that formula is CPI, and I'm going to talk to you about CPI in just a moment. So that's the EAC. The BAC is the baseline cost, so that's the cost as in our saved baseline. And finally, the VAC column is simply BAC minus EAC. So again, if everything was zero, everything would be perfect. Positive is good news, negative is generally bad news, and it's mostly negative in this project at the moment. Now let's take a look at one of the other earned value tables. Let's look at earned value cost indicators. So in this table, by default, the first two columns are PV and EV. Then we have CV. And then we have CV percent, and CV percent contains the ratio of cost variance to budgeted cost of work performed, expressed as a percentage. Now, this is a very useful statistic, because whereas with a figure such as CV equals minus $400, for instance, for task 2, it's useful to be able to put it into some kind of perspective. What does that minus $400 represent as a percentage of the value of the task? Now, in this case, it's 14% of the value. So that's quite a significant amount. If your CV percents are 10% and 8% and 11% and 13%, they're all fairly significant amounts by which cost is running over budget. Whereas if they're minus 1%, minus 0.5% and so on, then that's much less of a concern. The column to the right of that is CPI that I mentioned just now. And CPI is Cost Performance Index. And CPI, together with SPI that we're going to look at in just a moment, are two very important indicators. For tasks that are in progress or completed, we would expect the value of CPI to be 1 if everything has gone exactly according to baseline. In the case here, for the tasks that are completed or in progress, generally speaking, the value is below 1, which is not good and indicates a project that is running over budget, over cost. The final column there is TCPI. And TCPI stands for To Complete Performance Index. And the values here are intended to indicate what needs to be done to keep the project on cost. Now, I don't think this particular column has been implemented quite correctly yet, because you do get some rather strange values. For instance, this huge number here against task 2. Well, task 2 is complete, so there is nothing to do to complete it, and I think it's rather misleading having that number here. And also with TCPI, there isn't just one formula for calculating it. The formula for calculating TCPI is dependent on the status of a task. So values like this one, minus 0.02, can be somewhat misleading. So I'm not going to look at TCPI. We don't need it at the moment. Let's turn our attention to the third earned value table. That's the schedule indicators table. And the two columns there to point out are SV percent, so that's the schedule equivalent of CV percent, and again it gives you a good idea of the significance of the amount that you are behind of or ahead of schedule. Here you can see we've got -25%, which is clearly quite a bit, and then we have SPI, which is the schedule performance index. Again, the same rule applies as with CPI. You're looking for values of 1 for tasks that have started or indeed have completed. So, they're all of the key indicators. In the next section, we're going to look at an example of earned value analysis and reporting. So, I'll see you then.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right and check out our other Office 2016 tutorials below. I'll see you next week with new tutorials.